My name's Lindy Cowling. Welcome to my YouTube channel. My website is www.lindycowling.co.uk. My email is info@lindycowling.co.uk. And this short video is going to be called Falling Into You. No matter what steps we've taken so far along our journeys, there is one step that we cannot avoid, and it really is at the heart of everything. It's the integral heart of everything, and that is the step of falling into ourselves, of becoming, not only becoming fully aware of who we truly are, but also accepting who we truly are, embracing who we truly are, and resonating with who we truly are. We all have the opportunity to reach this point at some time in our journey, and it's a vital piece of our journey, because without facing that very heart of it, we cannot truly be in our wholeness and in our completion. Falling into you is the absolute journey into the relationship that you have with yourself. We have a divine awareness of this, awareness of it, but we've never been taught it outside of ourselves. And yet, the relationship we have with ourselves actually is the foundation of the relationship that we potentially have with everybody. And so you can see how vital it is, that important piece of the puzzle that we weren't, many of us, consciously aware of. Depending on if that piece of the puzzle has been dysfunctional or incomplete, or we've not been aware of it, that then forms the foundation for all the relationships that you go on to have with others. I could easily sit here and talk about self-worth and self-love, but that would only be words and concepts. Because what do we really mean about those words? What are we really saying when we say that? What we're really saying is the uncovering, I can't even use the word the letting go of, because that implies that there's some conscious awareness that you are holding on to something in the first place. And for most of us, there's not that conscious awareness or that conscious understanding of it. Because what we're being called upon to face has been buried under layers and layers of belief systems, under layers and layers of programming, under layers and layers of other people's stuff, under layers and layers of our childhood experiences or our adult experiences or trauma. And what we were downloaded, uploaded with, or experienced in our very early part of our lives gets entangled and taken on board by ourselves as something that is us. So I'm going to give you a simple example there. So if, for example, you were in a family with a parent or parents that deliberately or non-deliberately led you to believe that you didn't deserve their love and that you had to earn it, for example, then you would very, very quickly take this on as a child, a very young child, and that would be incorporated as your perception of the world, in your perception of the world and in your perception of who you are. And indeed, I brought out a video called, I think it was called Perception, Reflection, or something like that. Perception, Reflection, or something like that. I've forgotten what I've called it now, but I know it rhymed. Anyway, your perception of the world and your perception of yourself is, you know, integral to everything, because that will govern your behaviour, it will govern the relationships you choose, it will govern how you behave towards yourself, if you honour yourself, if you're aware of yourself, if you take care of your own needs. It will affect all of these things. So, when we talk about self-love, we're talking about making loving choices that are the best choices for you, the best choices for your health, the best choices for your growth, the best choices for your happiness, the best choices for your well-being. Not in an egotistical way, but in a way where you're actually being aware of your own being. Not what you've been told you are, or what you believe you are, but awareness of who you truly are. For me, it's a bit like, I see visuals of this, it's like digging a diamond out of the soil. You know, scrabbling away, digging the diamond out. All those different layers of stuff that we've been letting go of and uncovering. And then finding that diamond in the heart of it. And for me, the diamond will, you know, well, I always see the diamond as representing the multidimensionality, diamond consciousness. For me, I always see it as a diamond and the facets of a diamond. So falling into you is a step on our path that whatever we do, we can't avoid it. If we want to move forward, if we want to get into the highest expression of ourselves, the greatest expression of ourselves, the true expressions of ourselves, if we want to be hardwired into the source that we are 24/7, we cannot avoid falling into ourselves. We can try and avoid it, but we cannot avoid it if we want to progress in our awareness, in our wholeness and completion. And if we want to progress into the new energy, you know, as a result of the ascension templating and blueprinting. So, sure, I mean, many people, through their own personal choice, in fact, more people avoid journeying to themselves than actually go for it. That's simply because of awareness, because their own self has been so deeply buried under so much other stuff, because of the consequences of facing self, because as soon as you start to embrace and accept the real you and honour yourself, There will be some people in your life, a small minority, that will embrace that alongside you, but the majority of people, including friends and family around you, will find it difficult because your honouring your true self may not fit into what they would like you to be, or programmed you to be, want you to be, had controlled you to be. Variations on a theme, and that's going to trigger people enormously. The light of divine truth is extremely bright, and if people have got a lot of repressed stuff in there and they haven't chosen to do the work on themselves, they don't want to, or they've not even been aware of it, or you know, they're narcissists, psychopaths, sociopaths, whatever, and they're not going to do the work on themselves, the light of divine truth around people such as that that you may be interacting with is just too, it's just too bright for them, and they will react usually quite strongly, you know, and will leap out of your life, taking a chunk out of you before they go. This is why, even though it is uncomfortable for us to do so, why so many of us at a particular phase of this journey, this spiritual unfolding, almost have to, not really by our own free will very often, but almost have to be forced by our own higher self in a way to literally become hermits for a while, recluse for a while, and process our stuff, you know, essentially solo, without triggering people around us, without dealing as empaths, many of us, with other people's stuff, to get clarity and to have the actual peace and quiet and time to drop into ourselves, to fall into ourselves. Because it's only by recognizing the relationship that we have within, the relationship to who we are, that we can, in a more balanced and complete way than humanity has done before, progress into higher levels of spiritual partnerships and relationships. And like I say, you can do two-thirds of the equation, you can do two-thirds of the puzzle, but you are not going to be able to get away with this key part of it. Doesn't matter how many defense mechanisms, how many psychological techniques you've got within you to avoid this bit, how much you've been programmed with, downloaded with, got belief systems on. This dropping into yourself, this shedding the layers, this becoming fully aware of who you are. Not just fully aware of who you are, but embracing and loving of who you are. Letting go of all the other stuff on you, like judgments, which some of that you've been downloaded with, and some you've put upon yourself or yourselves because you've been downloaded with certain things or had certain life experiences. And you're going to have to just fall. You're going to have to do this fall into yourself. This doesn't matter if you are in a relationship with someone, in a marriage or not in a marriage, if you're doing it on your own. I mean, essentially, you're going to have to do it on your own anyway. This bit of it you have to do. I'm not saying that you can't call on assistance from other people, like, you know, for certain parts of it, if it gets a bit overwhelming with stuff coming up or emotions or whatever, and it won't be like that for everybody, but for some people it will. But you are going to have to do the free fall into yourself. And you know, the same applies to people that are in soulmate connections or catalysts or spiritual awakening connections, heart awakening catalysts, or, you know, twin flames, twin flame union, the same applies, but about, you know, 1,000 times more, because you know, they also also have to drop fully into the total love and honouring of who they truly are. It's no good them doing the love and honouring of who the other expression of their soul truly is. They've got to do the recognition of themselves. How will you expect, as a twin flame, somebody else to have that acceptance and recognition if you don't have it within your own expression of the soul? You can't expect the other to be able to maintain that for you. So, I mean, it's across the board, across humanity. It's personal choice again. Some people will choose to fall into themselves, come into a relationship with themselves as part of their evolution, and some will avoid it like the plague. Many will avoid it like the plague, because it's almost like we have to be forced into a corner to do it. We have to be forced to be fully present with ourselves, and most people can't do that when they're surrounded by other people. I'm not saying it's not possible, but most people can't do it with other people's input into that, because they're so heavily templated with all the family stuff and the society stuff that they can't do it. And am I saying it's comfortable? Hell no, it's not comfortable. No, spiritual evolution ain't comfortable. But it's just a part you have to go through, and if you want to get through it quicker, then you kind of just have to fall into it, and you just have to get on with it, really, and not try and avoid it. It's got to be done, it's just going to slow it down. Just before I sign off here, you know, that relationship with yourself, ironically, is the last thing. In fact, I don't think many of us in this world are ever taught about that. Certainly not in the Western world. We're always taught to, certainly in my generation, to get your needs met from outside of you. And for me, that was a massive baptism of fire, twin flame union, coming into a whole different awareness and a stage where you go beyond that and you realise, you know, nobody, that's not what it's about, nobody does that. You know, you have to be completely self-aware and not have any need or dependency for anyone else at all. I don't mean that in a, that sounds really harsh, I don't mean that in a harsh way, and that you don't need anybody. You just get to a point in your evolution where you're not dependent on that to know who you are or to function. It's a state of evolution again, you know. Like all stages of evolution, they're stages that we go through. So if you are at that stage when you're where you're falling into you, can't really say how long that will be, that stage, because I think it varies on you personally, how you're able to move through the process without too much of a fight, how you're able to, I just saw a huge flash of light go off by me then, so I just did a double take. Don't know if you saw that on camera. You know, or how you're able to do the work on yourself and face that, or how many times you want to run away from facing your thoughts, your feelings, your emotion, the truth, and ultimately change. Change within yourselves first and change outside of yourselves. Like I've said before, the most common event that human beings avoid is change. They like to keep things the same. Even when it's to their detriment, they like to keep hanging on to the same. That's kind of, you know, it's kind of basic human behaviour, actually. So, you know, it's interesting, but it's a stage that you can't avoid. And even if you think you've done it before, you know, that will come to your awareness as well. Actually, there's no final destination. You know, I'm sorry to say this. I know many of us are very, very weary, really tired. That's an important thing to say as well. Get as much sleep as you can, as much rest. Also balance that out with nature or the sea or rivers, you know, balance again. And try and get some decent nutrition if you can, fresh air. But yeah, there's no final destination. There's, you know, in this living embodiment, because as you reach one stage of awareness, you will find that you're still expanding, you're still evolving. The only way that differs is if you're a personality that has rigid control belief systems, rigid systems within, rigid belief templating, and you're in such a place of control and manipulation, either being done to you or you're doing it to others, or you've been so heavily templated that there's a stagnation take place, and then you know, basically just keep going around the same old wheel, really, you know, round and round on that same level of awareness. If you're on a level of awareness where you're expanding up through the heart, then that continues. It continues. I mean, that's a never-ending process of spiritual evolution. So no wonder we're tired. No wonder we're all tired. Because we're bringing that into the physical embodiment, into our bodies and our human experiences, which are changing rapidly. As we're changing rapidly inside, the outside experience is changing rapidly, which is really, you know, can be quite exhausting and quite challenging, actually. I think we all as human beings find the physical changes much more challenging to deal with than the spiritual ones, actually, because the physical ones normally require, you know, lots of sorting out, you know, in our world, changes of jobs, careers and finances and where you're living, what you're doing. But ultimately, you know, if we want to be true to ourselves, we can't bypass this stage. It's a vital stage. And it's the one out of all of the stages that we try and avoid. And yet, when we've got through that stage, you know, it's so much easier. Because if you can't fall back on yourself, who can you fall back on? If you don't know who you truly are, how the heck will anybody else know who you truly are? You've got to have that foundation. And for some of you, that foundation comes much later in life because you didn't have it because of your childhoods, your life experiences. You weren't given the building blocks there. So you're finding them for the first time now. So like I say, if you're falling into you, cut yourself some slack. Take a deep breath. And just move through it. Move through it. On that note, I will love you and leave you. Look after yourselves. It's a transformative year, 2016. Transformation means change. Change within and change without. So take care of yourselves while all these changes are taking place, both, you know, on the planet and within our personal expressions of, you know, our human experience. I'll love you and leave you. Thank you for watching and take care. Thank you. Bye-bye.